Welcome to the Bourbon Van.
I'm ready to rock!
Well, we got a bit of a strange bottle here today.
Mm-hmm.
It is Blackened Masters of Whiskey Series, the Wes Henderson edition. All we know is that Wes Henderson is responsible for Angel's Envy, and so when it comes to finishing whiskeys, He knows his stuff. He knows a thing or two, yeah. You might be wondering, why are there two glasses if you're doing one tasting? Well, this is a bourbon that's finished in white port casks.
I've never had it.
Me neither. And so I actually went to the grocery store and found the cheapest bottle of white port that I could find, a product of Portugal. All we really know about this is that it is likely fortified with brandy and is made from green grapes instead of red. So we really don't know what to expect, but we're going to try the whiskey and then we're going to try the wine, bounce back to the whiskey and see if there are similarities in flavor. Of course, we don't know what white port casks they used for this. It's probably not broad bend white Porto, but it might be. We honestly have no idea. By the way, the reason they call it Blackened is because they play Metallica music at a low bassy rumbling frequency to keep the whiskey moving in the barrels and gives it lots of interaction, apparently.
I like it.
Yeah, sure. I don't know if it's accurate or not, but
I don't know.
Let's rock.
Let's do it.
All right, it's this one that's the whiskey?
No.
It's this one that's the whiskey?
Yes.
Okay. The logo glass. All right, let's get onto the nose of this. I really have absolutely no idea what to expect here. By the way, this bottle, $100.
Yes.
Seems like every January we buy like a $100 bottle of whiskey and...
and regret it. Yeah. No, I'm just kidding. I have no idea.
Sometimes it works out, sometimes it doesn't. The other thing we should say about this bottle, I have no idea how readily available it is out there. I have to think not much. I know there weren't many here in Central Oregon.
Right.
Maybe it's available by you, probably not.
There's been a lot of gimmick bottles.
Mm-hmm.
We've liked a couple.
We have.
We've hated a couple.
We have.
So let's see where this one lands.
Let's check it out. Let's go to the nose on this.
Yeah.
There is a wine presence here.
Oakiness underneath. It's almost a little sweet.
Yeah, it smells sugary, smells like bourbon, but with a little bit of wine. It is 116.2 proof, so there is some heat coming off of this, as you would expect.
I'm interested to try this.
Yeah, it's a little, it smells funky. Cheers.
Mm. Oh, wow. It's very citrusy.
It was weird.
Yeah, the oak kind of came through right at the beginning, and then all of a sudden I got tons of almost like lime or some sort of citrus note.
Like an orange candy, those chewy candies you get in the checkout line at the grocery store that are always stale.
Yeah.
There's some of that on the finish, and it's sort of like hanging out on my tongue. It's weird. It's hanging around forever.
It's got a nice warmth to it.
There's a cinnamony spice that pairs nicely with that citrus that's hanging around.
Mm-hmm.
Some flavors here I don't recognize from other bourbons. It's a little hard to identify.
I want to take a few more sips and kind of dig in a little bit.
I think it's a great idea. There's a nice vanilla that's peeking through now.
Kind of
pulling the curtain back and looking in there.
And I'm getting some nice tobacco before that citrus hits. It's an interesting drink because, man, it is front-loaded with oak and tobacco and maybe like some like darker licorice flavors.
Mm-hmm.
And then that finish is all citrus.
It's got flavors like an onion. You just keep on ripping those layers off and there's more to find there. It coats really nicely. It's kind of dense and thick, but it's really lively on the palate.
So is the idea of this, because of those sonic vibrations, that it's supposed to get more oak into it or just more of the flavors overall? So more of this white port kind of finish integrated with the bourbon itself.
I suppose integration with the barrel would include all of those things.
I
don't know. I'm not a whiskey scientist.
I know.
I kind of wish I was.
I wish I was too.
One more sip and then we're going to check out the wine.
While I was sipping this, the nose had a nice chocolatey note. Mmm.
There is a weird chocolate to this, but it's not normal chocolate.
It almost tastes like baking chocolate, like something that you would have during the holidays or something that, like, pre-sugared.
Is it white chocolate? Maybe, is that what that weirdness
maybe
is?
Maybe it's like a white chocolate on this one versus like a milk chocolate. But to me, it doesn't taste super sugary. It just has that chocolate note. So almost like, you know, those barks that you can sometimes get?
Yeah.
That's what it kind of tastes like.
And there is a sort of dry chalkiness that pairs with it here that's... I don't dislike any of it. It sounds weird. There's a million weird things happening here. So we're trying to be accurate with our tasting notes, but
You know us.
We're not experts. All we do know is whether or not we like something, and we try to share as many notes as we can come up with.
I'm actually pleasantly surprised.
I didn't expect a lot.
I love gimmicks, but like I don't like spending a lot of money for them. And I'm pleasantly surprised by all the flavors. And I don't know if I'm qualified to call this cohesive at this point of my experience.
Sure.
But there's so many flavors in there that if at the end I decide that it's balanced, then kudos. Because there's a lot going on in this glass.
Absolutely. Well, let's set this glass aside for the moment. I want to check out this port wine, the white port, and see
what it's supposed to taste like?
Yeah, let's find out. What is that? You're just Last jacked up over here.
Port.
Woo! Woo. How about that?
Jeez.
That's not my favorite thing.
It smells like grapes. It smells like fermented grapes.
It smells a little like brandy, though. The more my nose gets into this, the less I'm weirded out by it.
And it smells like grandma.
Your grandma is a big port fan.
It's
she wanders around with the gallon jug of it.
She loves it. She goes through the gallon. I hate to even know.
I mean, for a woman in her 90s, she gets after it, so good for her. She's not drinking white port, though.
Oh, no, for sure. Dessert port.
Yeah.
I talk about my grandma a lot on this show.
I like your grandma.
I do, too. I don't know what brandy's supposed to smell like. I know we've had things that have been finished in brandy, but I don't know if I've ever actually had brandy on its own.
We don't keep it around the house these days. We used to keep a bottle of like E&J VSOP around for whatever reason.
There's some in the cabinet.
Is there still? I'm getting a little butterscotch here on this wine, which is interesting. I think we go in for a taste.
Yeah, let's do this.
Here we go.
It tastes like communion wine. It does. Like there's a grape juicy wine. I don't know.
There is still a butterscotchy, white chocolatey thing happening here, especially on the finish. It's interesting enough. It's kind of strange that it's a cloying sweetness with a little bit of fruity brightness.
I actually like it.
I do too. I think it's interesting.
I don't know if you would ever drink this. Like, well, obviously people do drink white port.
Sure.
Well, I'm assuming people drink white port.
Or they cook with it or something. I don't know.
I bet you could cook with it.
It is 19.5% alcohol, so it's not a lightweight, not really.
What I find interesting is I can see people drinking this, but just like as a little tiny taster before a meal or even after a meal as like a palate refresher.
Digestif, something like that. It coats nicely. It is sweet. I couldn't drink a lot of it. But there are some similarities here. A little citrus, some whitish chocolate notes. Mm-hmm. It's interesting enough. I'm probably drinking it out of the wrong glass.
Yeah.
But all right. Good enough.
I'm mildly intrigued by that white port.
I'm intrigued to go back to this whiskey and see what we find now.
It smells a lot more like bourbon.
Yeah.
After having that port. I'm not getting any bitterness on this.
No.
I was kind of thinking with all the flavors, and sometimes when you do things wonky, you can get a little bit of that bitterness on any part of the sip.
Do things wonky.
Yeah. Well, I mean, this is kind of a weird experiment.
I completely agree.
Yeah. And I'm not getting that, which is a nice surprise.
I don't know what I think about it. I don't know if I like it. I certainly don't know if I love it, but I do know I'm intrigued by it. I'd like to sit with it and think about it for a while. It strikes me as the type of whiskey that is going to go through a ton of changes as we work our way down through the bottle with different drops of water or ice cubes. I mean, they sat for, what, 20 minutes before we did this tasting, so they've definitely had plenty of time to breathe, and that bottle was already open. So it's an intriguing whiskey. I don't know. I don't think I would. It's definitely not a definitely buy this bottle from me. It's a try. If you see it at a bar and it's maybe a $15 or $20 pour, which I would assume this would be since it's a $100 bottle, I would probably give it a shot. I think that there's other people out there that are big fans of Metallica or Wes Henderson or of Blackened in general. And if you're a collector and you want this bottle, then by all means, it's an interesting addition to your lineup. To me, it's a confusing whiskey that I want to spend a lot more time with. I am interested in it.
And on this side of the van, I like this.
Yeah.
Do I think you're paying $100 for the story? 100%. Do I wish it was less expensive? Yes.
Sure.
But I'm enjoying these flavors. I actually like the sip even more after I had a little bit of this white port, just to kind of even that out. I think the flavors are really interesting in here. It takes you on a ride. It's almost like being at the concert, right? Where you kind of maybe experience a lot of a different... Not emotions.
The ups and downs. Being in the crowd, the downs of waiting for the line at the bathroom.
Yeah.
Sure.
I overall think that this is kind of a nice drink. It's giving me a lot of flavor that you don't normally get bourbon. I mean, that citrus finish, that chocolate note, and I think it's not your general like dark or milk chocolate. I think you're right. Like, it's a white chocolate. You still get a lot of those bourbon flavors. It just is, it's kind of interesting. It's not... The taste isn't bitter. Yeah. The finish is nice. I think the proof point is nice. I think overall, it's a definite try if you get the opportunity.
Yeah, it's engaging. It's interesting.
Yeah.
It's fun. It's just like your friends here at the Bourbon Van.
I'm actually surprised to say this because I was really skeptical when you brought this bottle home. And I was like, I don't know. We're paying for the gimmick. And rarely does that live up to the expectations. Today, I think this sip is delicious. Now, will it be as delicious in a couple weeks, a couple months? Well, we'll see.
We'll see. Yeah, I think it's one we're going to spend a lot more time with. It is a fun bottle. We'll have to share it with friends and see what they think of it as well.
Yeah, it's a good story.
Absolutely. And speaking of good stories, if you are a Patreon supporter of the channel, right now, because we're reviewing a bottle that's Metallica-based, it's music-based, and why not? Julie wants to rock? Let's rock.
Let's rock.
20 years ago this month, I was playing in a band and we were recording an album and we broke up before it ever got released. And so Patreon supporters, when you're done watching this video, we finally discovered one of the long lost album singles. You can go to our Patreon page right now to check it out if you're a supporter. I can't promise it's going to be any good or any fun, but...
I think it's a lot of fun.
It's a little fun. It's a bonus for our Patreon supporters. So go check that out after you're done viewing this video. And if you've tried this bourbon or you've had this bourbon before, let us know what you think of it in the comments. It's super weird, and I'm looking forward to getting to know it a lot better from wherever we are.
To wherever you are.
Cheers.
Cheers. If you like to rock, give us a like.